from Cute as a Bow, and today I'm going to be showing you a DIY Pippi Longstocking Halloween costume slash hair tutorial. Now, I was Pippi Longstocking last year, and I went to this Halloween walk where you would go to your own station, you'd give everyone else candy, and then it was your turn to go to everyone else's station and get candy from them. And most of them asked questions like, how did you do it, or is there a wire there, or something like that. But I got a ton of compliments, and it was really fun going, so if you really want to be out there and have a really unique costume, then I think this is the way to go. So, before we get on the real costume hair part, I just want to point out a couple materials that you will be using for your costume. Now, this is the most important part, and yeah, it's a wire hanger, but it is what holds your hair up in place. I am using white. I would normally dye my hair, but today I'm not because unfortunately I do not have any dye with me, so it's okay if I use any kind of color. And the next thing you will need is some pliers, or are some pliers, and this is to bend your wire so that it will be in the outline of Pippi Longstocking's hair. If you don't need it, then you can just use your bare hands. I might just use my bare hands because those pliers are kind of tricky to work with. I don't know. Next thing are a pair of scissors. And if you want to do this to make your costume look more authentic, I just took this flower pattern because I thought it looked like Pippi Longstocking, or I thought it looked like patches, and patches that Pippi Longstocking would have on her clothes. So I just cut some of this up and I sewed it on one of the pieces of our costume. Now the next thing you'll need is some socks, a pair of mismatched socks. It's okay if they're not the same size. I just randomly took some socks that I thought were cool and I mixed them together. And the next thing is this white t-shirt. I just went ahead and I cut the sleeves off. And from the shoulders down, I made this little V. I just thought it looked cool. And I also took some of this fabric and I sewed it on to look like patches. Now you can put as many as you want on this, but try not to make it too overwhelming. So yeah, that's the back and that's the front. The next thing you'll need are some shorts, or I just took a pair of jeans and cut them up to make them look like shorts. They are kind of unraveled, but it's okay. The next thing are a pair of leggings. Now, I used gray. You don't want to use a really crazy color, like, I'm trying to say that you don't want prints on your leggings, like you don't want to have leopard prints or zebra prints. You just want them plain like this. The next thing, I have a really nice shirt, so I'm not going to be cutting up or sewing anything onto here. This is just a regular t-shirt with buttons and a collar. So, before I do the hair, I want to put on my costume because once you get those braids in place, then you can barely even walk out the door if your hair is really long. So let's get to it. First I have this coral shirt. Next I have the white shirt with all the patches on it. Leggings. I got the pants on. Alright, so I got it pretty straight. There are some bent corners, but that's going to be okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the wire on top of my head and I'm going to bend it and mold it to my head just like this. Alright, so it looks like we're done, but we're actually not quite finished yet. We're going to take a corner and just bend it just like this. And now I'm just going to... Whoa, this wire is not cooperating. I'm just going to kind of twist it around itself. So it's not quite twisted around itself, but as long as there aren't any sharp, pokey things sticking out, then you should be fine. And I'm just going to do this with the other side. Alright, so now that you have your wire all twisted around itself, I'm just going to check if there are no pointy edges. Nope. And I'm just going to put this on top of my head. And since this is impossible to actually get one hand and hold the wire in place the whole time while you're braiding, I'm just going to take a couple metal clips, clip the wire in. One more for good measure. And there we go. I'm just going to take the elastic out. I'm going to divide this hair into three equal parts. I'm going to take the left strand and I'm just going to cross it over the middle. I'm going to take the left strand and I'm going to flip it over the wire and over the middle strand. Again, I'm going to take this left piece. I'm going to cross it over the middle. Again, with the left strand, I'm going over the metal wire and again over the middle. Again with the left, again with the right, and I'm just going to be continuing this all the way down to the end of the wire. Alright, now that you have your braid all in place, I'm just going to take an elastic and I'm going to secure it. And there we go. That is the first braid. If you do have, if you can see a little bit of the wire, you can just pancake it and try to cover it up. And I'm going to be doing it with the other side. I have my Pippi braids in place, and as you can see, they are just in the air and wiggling around, and they are free. It is a really weird feeling, and I kind of like it. And now that you have done your Pippi braids, I'm just going to take the little metal clips out. Whoa, it's stuck in my hair. And if you want, you can take a couple bobby pins and pin down some flyaways, or if you have any lumps, you can pin those down too. And there we go. I know the wire is showing, but if I had any hairspray, I would cover it. But unfortunately, like I said before, I don't have any. So this is all I can do for now. Oh my gosh, these are the Pippi braids. They look so awesome. And if you do have any wire sticking up, you can always fix it and try to hide it. But yeah, that is all. So I think they turned out pretty awesome and funky, and I just can't stop wiggling my head. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed my tutorial on this awesome DIY Pippi Longstocking Halloween costume / hair tutorial. I am loving the fact that these braids are moving. I mean, look at them. It's just awesome. And hopefully you'll be able to try this costume out on Halloween. I know I will be doing it. And I will post some pictures on Instagram of me with this costume and with some red dye on my hair, so you'll see how that will turn out. And I will see everyone later. Goodbye.